I'm Colin. And I'm going to start by giving a quote that was something that was said to me by my late grandfather a number of years ago. And it was this. It was, if you don't like your lot in life, try losing it all and getting it back again. And I remember he said it to me and I thought, the old man's crazy. I had no idea what he was talking about. The truth is, it was very wise. It was really wise words. The reason I don't think that I understood it was because I didn't want to. At that point in my life, everything was going great. I also didn't understand that he had some personal experience with that, and that's where it was coming from. But at that point in my life, I was too wrapped up in me, and I was running at that point a successful business of my own. I had a nice home, family, everything was, why should I worry about words like that? Well, I'm not going to get into all the reasons that things happen as they happen, but what I will say is this. There came a day when the nice family disappeared, and I should have seen that coming. Again, being wrapped up in myself, I completely missed it, and I was totally blindsided. Now, some people can bounce back from something like that. I didn't handle it well. I completely fell apart. So when that happened, I lost the rest of my life. And I actually went into complete self-destruct mode. Didn't take long. A few short months, the home was gone, the car was gone, possessions were gone. And I was facing a very real prospect. I'd run out of options in terms of getting support from the rest of my family or friends. They didn't want anything to do with me, and I don't blame them, quite frankly. I ended up facing the prospect of ending up on the street, and I was absolutely terrified. And I pushed it off as long as I possibly could, and but it happened anyways, of course. And so for the next 3 years, I bounced between shelters, the streets, out of the cold, thank you, and really precarious housing. There were times in that 3 years where I was housed, but I didn't know whether I was going to be housed next week. I didn't know whether it was going to be some catastrophe that was going to cause me to lose my housing. And a lot of this housing was extremely substandard in quality. Moldy walls, you know, plumbing that didn't work, you name it, I've seen it. So that went on for about 3 years, and there's a few things that I just want to share about that experience. That the first was, I was completely shocked. I was so scared going into that situation. I was completely shocked when the people that I met on the street, people that I had been conditioned to believe were dangerous or dirty or whatever, turned out to be my allies. They were the ones that directed me to places where I could obtain food, clothing, hot shower, laundry facilities, basics of life. And to this day, many of them are still, I regard as very close friends, whether they're housed or not at this point. The other thing I learned really was profound to me was that if I couldn't fit it into a backpack, I probably didn't need it. And I've said that before. And it's true. It really, nothing like, you know, being kicked down a bit to put things in perspective. So that all that stuff I've been chasing all those years, all of a sudden it meant nothing. And I think Ken also alluded to that a bit too, but it's not important. Live simply. Then there was a couple of other things that happened. One was, I started watching people around me that were living in that same situation. They were living that homeless experience. Many of whom had been doing so for 15, 20, 25 years. And they started dying. They got sick and they died. And many of them at a really early age, 45 years of age. And I realized that, yeah, homelessness isn't good for your health. Imagine that. And I thought to myself, you know, I don't want to wake up when I'm 50 and realize that I've been living like this for the last 15 years. It's just not, you know, 3 is enough. And so that was a bit of a turning point for me. And then another thing came along, and it was this friend and I were sitting down one day, and you know, we were talking about my background, and I had some background in film, mostly in editing, and I'd always wanted to make a documentary. And we got talking about it, and we got really excited about making this little short documentary. Now, the film never happened, but what did happen was I through that process, I've met a lot of really, really neat people, including a professor at the Faculty of Social Work at Wilfrid Laurier, who was so supportive. And despite the fact that I was still struggling between the streets and couch surfing and precarious housing, she never looked at me funny. She never looked down on that. She looked at me as a person that had a creative idea that was something that she was enthusiastic about. And she was so supportive of it. And I started realizing, you know, all those skills that I have, that I haven't used for, you know, how many years, they're still there. I've still got them, and I can still use them. And for the first time in a very long time, I was enthusiastic about something. I was looking at something that I could do that would directly impact my future. It was the beginning of me taking back my own life. And like, so it didn't matter whether that project ever got completed. Maybe one of these days it will. But it started me on a different path. And then at one point through Out of the Cold, a gentleman from the Out of the Cold, John, came up to me, and he was talking about this new building they built, supportive housing in Waterloo, show. And it's up in Waterloo. And it was 30 self-contained one-bedroom units with whatever supports you might need for whatever issues that you're dealing with in your life. And I'd heard about this project a number of months before, a couple years before. When I heard about it, I was kind of skeptical that it would ever happen. But sure enough, he says, building's there. Can we put you on the list? And I got the call one day, and then I had been accepted. And I've lived there now for 3 years. And it has been life-changing for me. Having that stability really, now I wasn't worried about whether it was going to be housed next week, or whether the landlord was going to kick me, or whether the pipes in the walls were going to explode and force me to have to go elsewhere. It was stable. I knew that it was long-term. And I now had a real chance to get things together. And I had the desire to get things together, which was really, I think, part of it. It had to go both ways. And I'd run out of excuses for doing nothing. I had to. Around that same time, I started, this professor that I spoke about earlier asked me to participate, to speak to one of her classes. And I thought, sure, why not? I mean, what's to be afraid of? I mean, I've been on the streets. I lived that life. I mean, I never thought I could do that, yet I somehow managed to. So that started a whole roll of things where I started I started doing a lot of public speaking, and I started telling my story, and I started trying to reach out to people in the community, because by telling my story, we create awareness. And that's what this week is all about. It's all about creating awareness. It's the start of it. And so, in short, I'm going to get cut off here in a second. I haven't got quite there with the whole "if you don't like your lot in life" thing yet. I haven't got it all back yet, but it's coming. Thanks to the wonderful supports around me, and the things that I've been able to do. It's and the big thing is I finally understand what those words meant.